Good afternoon, Reddam. Welcome to RBS. My name is Liam Bolton, your student host. And today, we have the privilege and honor of being joined by Mr. Nadasen. Thank you for joining us today, Mr. Nadasen. The first question I have is, what are your first impressions and feelings of being in Reddam and the Inspired Education Group?
Thanks, Liam. Yeah, it's great to be here. You know, this is the last Reddam school that I'm visiting, and I think, like Stephen said, we saved the best for the last. No, but it's been an incredible 2 weeks for me. So I started last Monday visiting our schools, and I started in Cape Town and looked at our properties there. Mm-hmm. And I think it's been an amazing experience for me because I didn't realize that how unique each school is. And you know, I had this impression that all Reddam schools were pretty much the same from a look and feel point mm-hmm. of view. And it's been an incredible revelation for me, going around a school like Atlantic Seaboard in Cape Town and seeing the long history that it's got from being a monastery in years gone by, and Constantia used to be a part of a hospital during World War II, and Umhlanga, the ELS, used to be the original cane cutters accommodation from the 1900s, and it's just incredible that the stories that I've been able to learn about, and an incredible amount of passion and energy that I've felt in these schools.
Mm-hmm. And Reddam House says one of the has had one of the best responses and most equipped sort of platform in terms of e-learning. And how do you think that this differentiates the school, and how do you think that this has set a precedent for the future in terms of e-learning?
So I think from a managing disruption point of view, it's been exceptional. I mean, and I think for us, what we saw is for the first time is how important we are being connected to a global brand. And because, the coronavirus happened at various times around the world, we were able to learn quite nicely from learnings of schools that had already shut down in other parts of the world. So, from an online point of view, it helped us manage disruption and make sure that we were able to ensure that our students were able to cope and minimize the disruption in their lives from a learning point of view. Mm-hmm. And also, from a you'll see that quite a few of the days were full days, try and, not be that we were trying to, upset the normal routine. And I think we've been quite successful in that, managing that disruption. And that certainly has set us apart from some of the other schools because, we find ourselves where, whilst we've had major disruption in the world, the disruption to learning has been very minimal for us. But I think going forward, what we've also seen is very important is the amount of the need for social interaction. It's absolutely critical. Our schools are built for us to feel that energy, for us to be around people. And, there's such a deep sense of community that I feel amongst our students in particular when I visit our schools. And I think it's something that we want to encourage people to get back to, come back to school, be in the environment. The physical interaction is so important for our emotional well-being, being able to go out and do a pitch and do something outside and see your friends again and see people that we interact with. So I think it's so important. But going forward, I know from an Inspired point of view, we're currently looking at an online platform and are sort of, quite well into that. But it's not something that I think we will dabble in as an alternative to coming to school right now. Definitely. It might be a new option that we will explore.
Do you think that the more physical and social interactions is something that's key to the Reddam Inspired value?
Very much so. I mean, it's from a pillar point of view, it's absolutely critical that we have that social interaction and that physical interaction with people.
Mm. And if you could give an inspiring message to your younger self that would also inspire young Reddam students, what would it be?
I think be passionate. Don't lose sight that these are important years of your life. Have fun. And sometimes, I think, for me in particular, when you look back, hindsight's a great science, and it's an amazing teacher of things. But to be able, sometimes when you're young and growing up, you sort of don't want to listen to people because you think that you know better. And if I had to give myself advice, I would probably say, listen more and take advantage of the years that you're in and have fun. They're important years, but it's also important to have fun.
Okay, fair enough. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Nadasen. This has been your host, Liam Bolton, here at RBS. Thank you for joining us this lovely Friday afternoon, and see you next time.